Madison.
Do we need a microphone? Can you guys hear?
I can talk.
I'm not very loud, but can you hear me?
Yeah.
What?
Yes.
Cool. You're quiet. Always. All right, so we're just going to kick this off here. Set things. So what are some things that secular society, popular culture, the world, says that dating relationships between young people are supposed to be about, or how are they supposed to go? It's a question to you. Give me answers. Yeah. Anybody else?
Looking into each other's eyes for 2 hours.
Okay, that was just true. Long walks on the beach!
Playing
the
wind. Anything else?
Smooching.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, so all those things, you see them, some of them sounded like they were Hallmark cards and stuff, the long stairs and stuff. Baking cookies sounded like it could have been a euphemism. Which is one thing that popular culture seems to think that dating relationships should be about. Sometimes it's a lot of like physical stuff and sex. Sometimes dating is just for fun, you know, hey, whatever, just doing what I want. But most of all, I'd like to also point out that I think a lot of times when we see it on television or in anything, it seems to be temporary. Like, people are always looking for a person they want to be with, but you're somewhat expected to go through just multiple relationships and people and do what you want, and then whatever, we can just break up and stuff. My example for this is always Charlie Harper from Two and a Half Men. You know, he's got a different girl every day. It's just me.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's what I feel about.
So what would you guys say that the church would expect of
them? 5 foot radius.
Discernment.
The objective of dating would be to discern your vocation. So a vocation is like whatever path God is calling you on in life. So it could be like the single life or the religious life. And then in the case of dating, it would be to see if you're possibly married.
Mm-hmm. Now, some of you are young, / all of you are young. So you might be thinking, I like boys or I like girls, and I am in no way at the age to get married or anything, so what are you trying to say? Don't worry. It's just like the church is fine with young people dating, like I said, it's good, because there's a lot of good things that can come from a dating relationship or a serious romantic relationship. One thing is maturity. You know, you tend to grow up and learn how to do things more by yourself and with people. You get to know yourself better because you need to communicate and like convey that to the other person to help them know how you're feeling. Also, it helps you be more selfless, because basically if you're ever going to keep a date or a relationship going, you're going to need to learn how to care for the other person's need instead of your own all the time. What we're mostly trying to say with how this is for discerning marriage in your case is just, it's important to always be honest with yourself and the person that you're dating. If you don't see it going anywhere, and if you like really don't think it's going to be a serious relationship, you don't really care, you might want to consider why you want to date the person, and if instead you're just using them. Why lead someone on? Because that person doesn't really care about it. So yeah, don't let it scare you. Dating's still great. It can be fun. You can make friends through things. You know, hey, want to come up to the movie, the game, the show?
Yeah. So what you always have to keep in mind though is that in any sort of relationship with another person, whether it's like a business relationship, or just a friendship, or a dating relationship that you're talking about, is that our primary duty is the church usually explains this in terms of love and use. So to use someone means that you use that person for your own gain, whether that's for something like physical pleasure, or using them as an emotional dumping ground for you, or to use them for some sort of status thing, like it's cool to have a boyfriend, so you have a boyfriend. But these things are all opposed to what true love is, because true love is to always look out for the good of the other person. So in this way, Catholic dating differs from other types of dating, in that you always have to be aware of what you're doing to the other person. So for example, giving someone for physical pleasure is a trap that a lot of young couples and a lot of people in general fall into. It's very opposite of what real love actually is.
So in popular culture today, and especially in relationships between young people, like she said, there seems to be a big focus on the physical side of a relationship, which, don't get me wrong, physicality is still good. I mean, it's okay to like kiss the person you're going out with, kind of nice. But a view of love where it's like all the focus seems to be on physical things is skewed and falls short of God's actual plan for relationships between men and women. But if you do feel like you're being called to, you know, try out dating or in a serious relationship, there's lots of ways to express and foster real love without resorting to sex or over, hey, we just want to all the time. I left a blank there. Anyways, make cookies. I like that one. Make cookies, but I said make cookies. That's why it's a euphemism. It sounds like cookies. Alright, but anyway, so there's a couple ways.
So some things that you can do with the person you're dating or in your relationship to sort of foster love. The first thing that you suggest is to pray together. So praying together helps to center your relationship in something bigger than you, because if you try to do this alone, you're going to not do as well. So try to keep God at the center of your relationship. Christopher and I pray together. Say the rosary together if you can, be loved to go to Mass together, or you put adoration to the person, but just always make sure to keep God involved in the relationship.
It's a big account. Another thing is be honest, actually. Be completely open about everything. You have to make sure that you're communicating your needs and the other person's needs. Because basically, if something's going wrong or you don't like something, or come out somehow, okay? Like, if you don't tell it now, it's going to come out later and it might be a little more nasty. That's basically how it goes down. So, you need to be honest about everything. That can be being honest about your plans for the future, you know, individually, like maybe you have a certain job you thought you might be and stuff, plans for the future with them, so where you see the relationship going. You can even have to be honest about your feelings about sex or physical things. Because, like I said, physicality is still a good thing, but the problem is, apart from, you know, general lines like, hey, don't have sex before marriage, it's like, people are comfortable with different things, and you want to make sure that you're on the same lines, otherwise, some people could feel like they're being used, and it can lead to a lot of other problems that way. I also have to point out that you should make time for the other person that you're going out with or on to date. This is something that I've learned is very important, because I'm a busy little Catholic bee. I just threw Catholic in there to make myself look better or something. I'm not actually obsessive compulsive, but I get crazy over things, and I focus too much on work, sometimes I can use Sarah at the wayside sometimes, and it can actually cause a lot of trouble. And so basically it's just like, if you feel that, you know, relationship's being called towards something bigger, then that person's going to play a large role in your future, and is already is very important to you. So you have to make them an integral part of your life. So you have to